We're going to illustrate use of the simplex method on a non-standard problem with the examples shown here. Minimize c equals 6x plus 4y. We have three constraints, 6x plus y greater than or equal to 60, 2x plus y greater than or equal to 40, and x plus y greater than or equal to 30, along with the usual non-negative constraints. So there are a lot of things that make this a non-standard problem. We're minimizing something, and all three of these constraints are greater than or equal to constraints. So the first thing we have to do is to turn these three constraints into less than or equal constraints by multiplying each of these inequalities by minus 1. When we do that, we're led to this set of three inequalities. And it's these three inequalities into which we need to introduce our slack variables. So we do that in this next step, letting our slack variables be represented by u, v, and w. So these are the three equations that will go into our initial simplex tableau representing the constraints, but we also have to introduce the correct representation for what it is we're minimizing. In this case, c is this expression, and since we're minimizing, we flip around and look at the negative. D being minus c is minus 6x minus 4y, and when we put that in standard form, the equation for d, taking the x and y terms over to the left, becomes 6x plus 4y plus 4d is 0. So when we take that final equation shown here, match it up with the three that we already had, we wind up with these four equations as being the four equations for which the augmented matrix for this system of equations becomes our initial simplex tableau. So I input that augmented matrix as the initial simplex tableau into the row operations tool to begin my work. Once again, I remind you that after you've typed in your matrix, it's a good idea to click on Save This so you can go back and start over if you make a mistake. And again, I have optionally labeled my columns just to help me keep straight of where I am. I have my X and Y column for my initial variables, my U, V, and W columns for my slack variables, my D column, and the numbers that were on the right sides of the equations. And again, I'm going to try working in fraction mode and see how it goes. So now when we start, since we're looking at a non-standard problem, we expect to see these negative numbers over here. So let's just grab the minus 60, slide to the left, and I find a minus 6 and a minus 1. I can use either the X column or the Y column as my first pivot column. Let's use the Y column since it has nice simple numbers in it. Minus 1 into minus 60, minus 1 into minus 40, minus 1 into minus 30. The smallest ratio is 30, obtained with this candidate for pivot element. So the minus 1 will be my pivot element if I'm going to be choosing my pivot element from the Y column, which I'm doing. So that's my first pivot element. I pivot on selection. And now where do we stand? We still have some negatives in this far right column. Let's use the minus 30. To the left of minus 30, I see a negative in the W column and in the X column. Let's work with the W column. It looks nice and simple. Checking my ratios, minus 1 into minus 30, minus 1 into minus 10. This is not a candidate for pivot element because minus 1 into plus 30 does not give me a positive ratio. The smallest positive ratio is minus 1 into minus 10. So that's my next pivot element. I click in that box and say pivot on selection. And I've now finished my second step. And I still have this minus 20 sitting up here. So I still have to keep working because I'm still dealing with a problem that has non-standard features. Minus 20 has a minus 1 to the left of it in the V column and a minus 4 to the left of it in the X column, so I can use either of those columns as my next pivot column. Just to be cantankerous, let's slide down here and use the X column. minus 4 into minus 20 is 5. 1 into 10 is 10. 2 into 40 is 20. So I guess minus 4 into minus 20, which is 5, is the smallest ratio working in the x column. So the minus 4 will be my next pivot element. I pivot on that selection, and now I no longer have any negatives over here. I do have a negative in the bottom row, so I focus my attention on it. Above the minus 1/2, the minus 4 into 5 does not give me a positive ratio at all. 1/4 into 5 will give me a smaller ratio than 1/2 into 30. So the 1/4 right here will become my next pivot element. I pivot on selection, and I can see that I'm now done. I'm still clear of negative numbers over here in the final column, and I have no negative numbers down here in the bottom row. Remember, this guy doesn't matter. So I'm finished, and it's a matter of interpreting what our final solution tells us. We start by identifying which columns are not in basic form. They are the V column and the W column, which do not have a 1 and the remaining number 0. So we set those slack variables equal to 0, and then blocking out those columns, we read off the information in each row. The first row says x is 10. The second row says the slack variable u is 20. The third row says y is 20. And the fourth row says that d is minus 140. So the conclusion we draw with regard to our initial problem is that the minimum value of C is plus 140. What we actually showed was that the maximum value of D is minus 140. Remember, that allows us to conclude that the minimum value of C is plus 140, and that that value occurs when X is equal to 10 and when Y is equal to 20.